Yes. Well, it's getting on to be 9 weeks until I go on my train trip to see the total eclipse of the sun. This past weekend, on Sunday, was my stepfather's birthday. If he had not left us 10 years ago, shortly after his 90th birthday, he would have been 100 years old. I don't feel like I've lived here for 10 years, but this summer it will be 10 years since my mom asked me to come and help her keep the house. It's been hard watching her get older and weaker, and she's still getting around, but she uses a walker now. She sleeps more than 12 hours a night. She's out in the front of the house right now, playing solitaire on the computer, and I'm here using my laptop. When I get the nerve and the will and the urge to edit video, I usually do it on the more powerful machine that she's using right now, which means I either have to work late at night or early in the morning before she gets up. This was one of my stepfather's favorite wines. It's a Rosemont Shiraz from Australia. We had a couple of friends from Australia by coincidence here yesterday for lunch. They were delicious. We did. But she'd seen the Twilight Zone show To Serve Man. She knew what I was talking about when I said the aliens were fattening us up for the harvest. Anyhow, it's 9 weeks now till I go on my trip, and every day I've been checking the Amtrak website to see when my train arrives in Kansas City or St. Louis or San Antonio. And they've quite regularly been late, half an hour, an hour, sometimes 2 hours. One time, just this past week, the train got to Kansas City 4 hours late. So I'm really glad I've given myself 8.5 hours between trains in Kansas City. I just hope we're not too late so I'll have time to go down to the city market and walk out onto this little bridge they've built that you can go out and look at the river, the Missouri River in Kansas City. Anyhow, I've been watching to see how late the trains get in. Sometimes they're a few minutes early, sometimes they're a few minutes late, and sometimes they're an hour or two late. And like I said, that one time it was 4 hours. So all in all, I think I've got a good chance of not actually missing any trains. I just hope that there's no other problem than being a little late. Oh, I also hope it's sunny, that it's not overcast on the day of the eclipse, 'cause I would love to see the total eclipse of the sun. That reminds me, I have to buy sunglasses, and not just sunglasses, but solar eclipse glasses. are very, very dark, extra super dark. And I've still got some work to do before I go. There's a couple of projects I'm waiting to be sent to me right now on email. But I've got 9 weeks. I've got plenty of time to do them. And I just finished one. The deadline was Monday, and I finished it late Sunday evening, and then looked it over Monday morning and emailed it off to my partner, who's actually runs the agency where I'm a self-employed contractor with her. I'm going to have to file income tax this year, which is good news and bad news. The bad news is I have to file income tax, and the good news is I've made some money. So, and we've got a couple of new clients, too, at the University of Mexico. So, very slowly, the word is getting around, and we're starting to build a client base, and I'm starting to get paid. So I'll have to take care of that. And that means I'll have to have invoices made up. I can keep a record of how much I charge and how much I'm paid and all that. And then business expenses. Once I get the income tax straightened out, I'll probably buy myself a new computer, and that'll be a business expense that I can deduct. Anyhow, I'm getting ready to go. It's already 7 minutes. Look at that. The timer says 7 minutes. Oh, dear. I've been watching y'all making your videos about life going on, and I thought I'd just put my oar in the water and paddle a little bit. Life is going on, ain't it? Yeah. Oh, I was talking about the Australian friends. They the wife actually was born here and grew up here in the U.S. in California, in San Diego. And she went to Australia and ended up marrying an Australian guy, and she's been living there ever since. Well, her mother was still here, and mother's the age of my mother, and she just lost her mom about a month ago. She had to fly all the way. She's been coming 2 and 3 times a year the last couple of years to see her mom and help her. And it's not been easy, especially now that it's over. You're reminded of how fragile and how short life is. So, they were here, and they probably won't be back for a long time now. And we had them over here for lunch and sat around and talked for 2.5 hours. We just sat around and ate sandwiches and talked and had ice cream and talked. And well, I didn't have any ice cream, but my mom and they did. Oh, good grief. 9 minutes. Time to go, my friends. I love you. I'll see you next time I talk about how it's just a few more weeks until I go to see the total eclipse of the sun.